Ooh, pretty. I like how shiny the sun is. Hi.
Listen, I'm sorry. I didn't know you had feelings, okay?
Okay. I forgive you.
Oh, really? Great!
Hey, who are you?
My name's Bella. What's yours?
I'm Curtis. Sorry, I thought you were a tree.
Have you always talked to trees, Curtis?
No. They only started talking recently. How can I cut down trees when they're screaming at me?
Maybe you shouldn't cut down trees then.
But I'm a woodworker. If I can't cut down trees, where will I get my wood?
What are they screaming at you?
All kinds of really personal insults, like really over-the-line type stuff. It's been rough. But the worst part is not having any wood to build stuff with.
So you're a woodworker. Could you make me something?
Like what?
A weapon to kill Mogchathra?
That dude is a bummer. But I don't think I could make something that powerful. How about a nice three-legged stool? Yeah. I haven't done a stool in so long.
Okay, make me a stool.
I'd love to, if only I had some wood.
Listen, about that big mess upstairs.
Oh, did another tree fall on my roof?
Yeah, that's it. A tree fell on your roof.
That's cool. I needed a little fresh air in here anyway. Been kind of cooped up for too long, you know?
Will you help me kill Mogchathra?
Sorry, conscientious objector. But I'm not using my axe. You're welcome to it.
Ooh, think I could kill Mogchathra with that?
Oh, well, no. I really don't think anything could kill Mogchathra.
Catch you later, Curtis.
Beware the trees!
Hey, here's some wood.
That wood is playing a vital security function where it is.
Someone's ripped the trees out of this painting.
They were looking at me.
I feel like I should get to know that guy before I steal his art. Hi.
Hey, Bella.
Hey, about this art.
Yeah?
What is it?
Well, you know. It's abstract. It's kind of a tone poem, really. I find it does some interesting things with the space between viewer and image.
Okay. Where'd you get it?
I bought it from this slightly shady girl from Shell Mound. Said she was selling it to get money to move out of town.
Aren't you bothered by its elitist themes?
I probably would be, if I had such a superficial understanding of the work.
How do you know it's hanging right side up?
Because the dude's little feet go on the bottom, duh.
I like how it matches your decor.
Decor? I don't have a decor. The purpose of art is not decor, man.
Why do you have it up then?
I only had it up there ironically, but I was actually getting sick of it. If you like it, just take it.
Really? Okay. Catch you later, Curtis.
Beware the trees.
Okay, I'm taking this.
Cool. I liked that kind of stuff when I was your age, too.
What's this supposed to be? A little man with a bad haircut?
I guess at first glance one might see it that way.
You ripped the trees out of this painting, too?
No, that one was ripped when I bought it. Wear and tear are part of the charm of a vintage item.
You using this axe?
Not until those trees stop talking.
Okay, then.
Please don't tell the trees I'm in here, okay? And when you hit the main trail, head east. There is an extremely territorial snake in the other direction.
Gotcha.
Wait, east? Or was it west? Meh.
I could get used to carrying an axe around. Feels nice. This guy hasn't gotten mail in a while. Okay, which one of you trees has been bugging Curtis? They don't seem too chatty to me. Wait, is this east? West? Hey! Let go! Can't breathe. In case of snake, blow horn. You're welcome, Curtis. Okay, so do not go that way. Got it. Okay, now I see why the trees were freaking him out. It's trying to say something, but doesn't have a mouth. Do I want to help this tree talk or not? I have a feeling I might regret this.
Murderer! Axe-wielding psychopath right here!
Shh. You'll wake up the other trees.
She's got an axe! Run! She's a murderer!
Okay, look. I'm getting rid of the axe, okay? Just stop screaming, please!
My trunk! I'm losing sap!
Murderer!
Please don't scream anymore!
You can't silence me! I'm going to wake up this whole forest!
I'm here on behalf of Curtis, the lumberjack.
That homicidal psychopath? I once saw him hack an old lady to death.
Wow. Really?
Yes. A 300-year-old spruce, mining her own branches, then he comes along. And the next time I see her, she's a... Oh, God, if I say it, I think I might be sick.
Say it! What did Curtis do to the old spruce?
He butchered her! Turned her into a stool! Oh, God! I think I just threw up in my mouth a little bit.
Why are you so upset?
I just can't stand by in silence while you murderous humans mutilate my brethren! It makes me sick!
Are you magic? Can you help me kill Mogchathra?
Is that all you humans think about? Killing? You all make me want to puke.
You got a little something in the corner of your mouth.
Oh, that's just a little sap. I'm not ashamed. It's thick and natural, and I'm full of it.
Yeah, you are. I've never seen a talking tree before.
Well, I've seen plenty of axe-wielding murderous humans, so get lost.
I'll let you get back to your screaming.
Yeah, please leave before I vomit, you foul, rootless stump.
Hello, Shellmound. Looks like Mogchathra hasn't gotten here yet.
Steady.
Oh, no, driftwood. So smooth.
For the tide! Okay, now flip it and stick.
Excuse me, Mayor?
What? Mayor? Why did you say that?
Because you look like a mayor.
I have to admit you're not the first person to tell me that. But alas, I am merely Maiden's Feast Marshal Dune, a humble man of the people, for now.
I need to enter the Maiden's Feast.
Child, at this point, we may not even have a maiden's feast. Not that you have the right scent for it anyway.
Are you saying I smell bad?
Oh, heavens no, child. You smell like birthday cake and fluffy clouds. With a hint of fresh pine. Ooh, and a dangerous undernote of snake, I believe. Very nice. But that's just not the sort of aroma that hooks the big fish. Talk to your grandmother. I'm sure she has a fragrance recipe she'll share with you.
Did you say there might not be a maiden's feast?
The sea, she is angry this day. I'm trying to build the offering arena, but the waves keep washing it away.
There has to be a maiden's feast. I need to kill Mogchathra.
Yes, yes, we all want to fill Mogchathra. But when he comes here and sees no offering arena, he might pass us by, or worse.
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
Can I have it?
Certainly not. It's an integral part of my soon-to-be mayor look.
Why do you build the offering arena so close to the ocean?
Because that's where the sand is.
So, you're running for mayor of Shellmound?
My hopes and dreams. Just sand castles built too close to an angry sea. I had hopes, child, but this construction debacle under my marshalship has washed them all away.
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
Can I please have it?
I like your manners, but I like my hat more.
When is Mogchathra supposed to get here?
Any minute! So much to do!
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
It looks terrible on you. Might cost you the election.
Please, whom am I to trust? My highly paid stylist? Or a girl wearing half a dress?
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
It looks great on you. Very fancy.
What? Fancy? But I'm a man of the people. I'm never going to win this election if I come off as haughty and elite. Here, take this away from me. Thank you, child. I'm firing my stylist tomorrow.
Better let you get back to the feast.
Yes, yes. These maidens aren't going to serve up themselves.
Okay, let's try it there.
Oh, driftwood. So smooth. It's empty. Check it out! Non-talking wood!
Oh, and it's so smooth! Oh, man! I feel a stool coming on.
What? Oh, whew, that's a relief.
Tell me about it. I feel 10 times better. Thanks for helping me get that out of my system. I want you to have it.
Really? Thanks!
No problem. I like to spread my samples around.
You know, that Curtis looks like such a slacker, but he sure can bust out a solid stool. Can I have some of your sap?
You're just like the rest of them. Want to bleed us dry, steal all our thick, luscious, and incredibly useful fluids. You humans make me want to throw up, but I won't do it, because I refuse to give you the pleasure of my sap.
I'll let you get back to your screaming.
Yeah, please leave before I vomit, you foul, rootless stump.
sorry to do this to you, but...
Oh my god, is that mutilated tree flesh?
You see, what Curtis does is he peels off the outer layer of the wood to get to the tender stuff inside. Then he dips the whole thing in an acid bath before he begins the deep carving. Oh, sorry, did that upset you?
You monster!
Wow, it's getting thicker every second.
Strong stuff, kid. Don't mess with it.
It's already soaking into the ground. I have to catch it when it's fresh.
Oh, and now you're decorating me like a Christmas tree? Is there no end to the humiliation?
You can still see the grain of the wood. Wow, the sap is super thick. These fishing poles are useless. All the hooks have been stolen. Looking at this chum trough makes me really happy I grew up in a baking town instead of a fishing town. I just hope my baking town is still standing.
Perfect! Now let's see if this one...
Hi! You maidens getting ready for the maiden's feast? I want to be in the maiden's feast.
Of course you do, poor thing.
But shell maidens are chosen only after a long period of qualifying events.
Also, our dads are pretty powerful. Also, can I tell you something? Just as a friend.
Oh my god, yes, just as a friend.
You just don't smell right, girl.
Oh, I'd want a friend to tell me that.
Hey, can I have some of that perfume?
That's not perfume. That's a proprietary luring compound known as Beast Hooker.
It's irresistible to Moggs.
Hey, can I have some of your Beast Hooker?
That's better. But no, you can't. Sorry.
It's her secret sauce.
How about just one little squirt?
Sorry. If I'm not gonna give any to my best friend, Drusilla, I'm certainly not gonna give any to you.
I said I don't want any. I don't use performance enhancers.
Nice costumes.
Thanks. Our dads made them.
They're the best fishermen in the village, so they're pretty good at tying lures.
We had to use every hook in town, but it was worth it.
Isn't somebody gonna miss those hooks?
Not as much as they're gonna miss us.
You're gonna make me cry, girl.
Hey, maidens. I'm going to kill Mog Chothra.
Ha! Not half as hard as I'm gonna kill it.
I'm already killing it, in this outfit, just standing here.
You maidens nervous?
Yeah, nervous that Marshal Dune isn't gonna get the offering arena ready before Mog Chothra gets here.
Oh, I can't believe our dad's donated so much to his campaign.
Don't you guys ever wonder if there's another way? To save the town, I mean.
This is how it's always been done.
Yeah, they figured out how to do it a long time ago, so we wouldn't have to think about it.
See you maidens later.
Ciao!
Is this your secret stink for attracting Mog Chothra?
It's my grandmother's traditional cocktail of musk, pheromones, and animal sweat. And I'm not sharing it with anybody.
Well, I don't need it anyway. Daddy says I exude it naturally.
Let's cut this ribbon already.
You tell him, non-maiden.
The ribbon is there for your protection. The arena is still under construction. Okay, a little to the left. Watch out for the cross.
Here, this will make your sand mixture stick together better.
Really? How do you know?
I'm a baker. I know my ingredients.
At this point, I'd try anything. Hey, Clarence! Bring that load down here, will you? I hope you're right about this.
It's never failed me before.
How many times have you used it?
Never. Shh. Let's watch.
Here comes a wave. I can't look!
What'd I tell you?
Now that's a sandcastle. Looks like we're in business. All we need to do now is get those maidens in tune. All right, girls, time for the talent portion. Let's practice. Oh, Mark, shine your light on me, okay?
Oh, Chandra!
You can see the whole Maiden's Feast area from up here. This pyramid has a very unusual top.
A sighted stranger approaches. Not so fast. Darn, all out of holy tear gas.
Use the staff.
Oh, yeah. Halt! The Deadeye God sees no one.
Who are you two?
I am Deadeye Dawn, and this is Deadeye Courtney. Hi.
What is this place?
The Deadeye Pyramid. Tomb of the Deadeye God.
As if you didn't know.
Can I go inside?
You wish to invade our holiest of shrines? Why?
Because you guys are guarding it, so it must be cool.
Oh, it is. Extremely cool. But no one enters the Deadeye Pyramid. No one. Well, unless...
What?
Well, if she could solve the riddle of Yorn... Oh, yeah. If she could solve that, then she'd definitely be worthy.
No problem. Could you remind me how the riddle of Yorn goes one more time?
You always take us down when we are in our prime.
Devour your sweet rewards, yet I'll return in time.
A child of mine will rise out of his rotten bed, up from a hidden pit, long after I am dead.
Whoa.
Yeah. Bring us the solution, and you may enter the pyramid.
Who's the Deadeye God?
The Messiah from the sky. Bringer of miracle objects. Someday he will rise to return our sight and begin the Battle of Volgentol.
Did your god bring any miracle objects that were like weapons? The kind that could take down a giant monster before it destroyed your home village?
Our god had such power and more, probably. I mean, really, we don't even know what half the stuff in there does.
What's the Battle of Volgentol?
The final battle between humans and Mogs. The end of our entire age.
Sounds promising. Did you say you lost your sight?
Yes, that happens when you blind yourself.
Oh.
If the Deadeye God has no need for sight, then neither do we.
Huh. Hey, can I get you guys something?
Like what?
Maybe a refreshing beverage?
No thanks. I've got a flask of barnacle juice under this robe. Diet barnacle juice over here.
Hey, can I get you guys something?
Like what?
Some more holy tear gas?
Oh yeah, here. Just fill that up for me if you could. Thanks.
Bye.
Sense you later.
It's all out of holy tear gas.
Let's practice. Oh, Mark, shine your light on me, okay?
Come to me, old chum. I mean, when is this not going to come in handy?
2, 3, 4.
Sup, maidens? Hey, are you guys good with riddles?
Of course we are.
Except the kind where there are words that have, like, two meanings.
Oh, yeah, and you think the word means one thing, but it actually means the other thing? Yeah, I hate those.
It's not like that, is it?
Maybe? Hey, can I have some of that perfume?
That's not perfume. That's a proprietary luring compound known as Beast Hooker.
It's irresistible to Moggs.
See you maidens later.
Ciao!
Ugh, gross, Drusilla. Don't you think I can smell that? Okay, this time it really wasn't me.
Hey, maybe this perfume is what's attracting them. I'll get rid of it.
Great! Ow! Great idea!
What about me?
Ow! I exude it naturally! She has to save whom she can't. Ow! I'll tell Mog Chothra about you, Drusilla.
It says Beast Hooker. Who wouldn't want that? Oh, man. The things monsters go for these days. Marshal Dune? Hey, do you know the answer to the riddle about the pits and rotten bed?
What kind of pits are you talking about?
Huh. Not sure. I need to enter the Maiden's Feast.
Well, I suppose I do owe you one for your help with construction.
Oh, my, oh, my!
Now that is how you attract a monster. You are in, my girl. My compliments to your grandmother. Truly monstrous.
This is all your fault. That's all hurt. I am a maiden of shell.
Don't worry. I'm going to help.
Do something!
What can she do? We're just too attractive to animals!
Shh! Here she comes again!
Check it out! Fruit!
No thanks.
These are our only robes. We don't want to get them all sticky.
It's the answer to your riddle.
But it's just a fruit.
With a pit inside!
Oh my god! It's so simple!
Why didn't we get that?
Oh, man! That's been bugging us all day!
But what does it have to do with the pyramid?
Huh? Oh, nothing. It's just something our friend Becky Yorn told us this morning.
She thinks she's so smart. I can't wait to rub this thing in her face.
So, can I go in there now?
Oh, yeah, yeah, whatever. Knock yourself out.
I'm going in.
Okay.
Guess this is where they buried their old god. It's that same religious symbol, but this one is recessed, like a socket.
You found my circuit control router. That's awesome. Now I can fire up the ship and get back to Laruna.
You're welcome.
Oh, yeah, thanks for finding my circuit control router. I lost it during the crash and couldn't find it anywhere. I drew pictures of it for the locals and kept saying, "Give me this, give me this." After a few years, I just had to put myself in cryogenic storage and hope someone smarter would come along and find it.
Are you the dead eye god?
Man, that's so embarrassing. The locals called me that when my spaceship crashed here, and I kind of went along with it because, well, you know, God.
Were you really dead?
Nah, I was just preserved in cryogenic suspension for 300 years? I guess all the locals I knew here are long dead. That's kind of a relief. They were a little annoying. Part of the reason I went into chrysolation, to tell you the truth.
Does the ship you mentioned have any weapons?
Hey, whoa.
There's a giant monster that is destroying villages and eating young girls, and it may or may not have already... My whole family might be... Anyway, I just need to take down a horrible monster. Will you help?
I mean, sure. I owe you one. But my ship didn't have any weapons that I know of. I'll dig around once I get this heap working and let you know.
Can I help?
Depends. You know anything about spaceships?
No. I'm just a baker from Sugar Bunting.
Sugar Bunting? Is that anything like Steel Bunting? When I first landed, there was this town called Steel Bunting that the locals were all afraid of. Apparently, it's full of badasses.
So we're standing in a spaceship?
Just the upper observation deck. The rest of it's buried underneath. I'm gonna need to fix more wiring before I can even gain access to it.
What's Laruna?
That's my home planet. Or at least it was. Who knows if it's even still there.
What's all this equipment do?
This is the main observation deck of my ship. So this stuff mostly scans for signs of life or habitable worlds. Anything that would help the mission.
What was your mission?
Operation Dandelion. Laruna was dying. The spaceship was supposed to give us a fresh chance and a new home. But instead, we crashed here.
How'd your ship crash?
I hate to think about it, but there's a chance it was me. I tried to hack into the ship's controls and take over. Then some weird stuff happened, and the next thing I know, I'm here.
Okay, see you later.
Uh-huh.
Ooh, pretty colors. Whoops!
Hey, that was my amplifying quartz. Without that, how am I supposed to read the data from the search beam?
Sorry. I'll get a new one.
Don't bother. All I really care about is getting out of here, and I don't need a search beam for that.
The bottom socket is empty.
Yes. You broke my amplifying quartz, remember?
I'm going to replace it. I swear. There. Good as new.
Actually, that's not bad. And you even got it in the right slot. Hey, put that laser coil back. That's how I generate light for my search beam.
I'm just cleaning it. On second thought, I don't like it there.
Hey, what are you doing?
I found a replacement for your quartz thing.
Maybe, but you put it in the wrong socket. You get that order wrong and you'll melt us down into a sad little puddle.
Nailed it.
What have you done?
Fixed your ship?
You put the amplifying quartz after the laser coil. If I powered up the beam in this configuration, I mean, the thermal feedback alone could melt down my entire ship. I could conceivably release the extra energy out of the targeting iris, but that would only produce a powerful weaponized... Well, heck, let's just call a death ray a death ray.
Yay!
And I told Becky, you're so ugly. I'm glad I'm blind.
Okay. The targeting iris has 300 years of rust on it, but it should do the trick.
I'll try to lure him into a good spot.
You can fire the weapon with this remote trigger.
Like this?
Okay, shut it down.
Clarence, was that you? Knock it off!
Just use quick bursts or that hacked circuit of yours will cause a meltdown up here.
I'm not sure how to thank you for this.
You know what? The whole time I was on that spaceship, all I really wanted was to be as useful as I feel right now.
Well, wish me luck.
Hey, if you're really from Steel Bunting, I'm sure you're not gonna need it.
All right, girls, time for the talent portion.
You made it!
Yeah, after you took that beast hooker away, they eventually left us alone.
Thank you so much, non-maiden.
See you maidens later.
Ciao!
This is how I fire the Deadeye Pyramid Beam, and the time is right.
Ready when you are, Marshall.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's showtime! You know what to do, girls.
Beat you with one arm tied behind my back, but not two. Do it!
There's more where that came from.
Now! Ugh, it's charging back up. Hit it! Take the shot!
Ooh, sounds like that hurt.
Good! His mouth is closed! Short things! Can surprise you! Ha! Whoa! Do it!
Die, you monster!